Hey there, wine fans. Welcome back to the Reininger Weekly Blog. And today's tasting, we are going to be doing our Helix, our 2016 Helix Cabernet Sauvignon from Phinny Hill Vineyard. It's $30 a bottle. And what's really cool about this is you're doing a great thing by purchasing a bottle, because 10% of the proceeds go to a great cause, and that is Spokane's chapter of Second Harvest. The proceeds go to providing emergency food services and provides food for the food banks and meal programs. So with that, we are going to move on to doing a little tasting. So we better crack this puppy open and I don't know if you guys heard that crack or not, but I love a screw cap. So do you realize that one of the first screw caps is Plum Jack? It was a cult wine, or is a cult wine, I should say. And yeah, they gained recognition being one of the first 100-point wines, screw cap wine, just like this. So let's go ahead and check it out. First though, before we start talking, man, oh wow, this is going to be a fun one. Let's just talk about Cabernet Sauvignon itself. Cabernet Sauvignon is known as the king of red wines. It's known for its concentration, its aging ability, and it's grown all over the world. And the reason why it's grown all over the world is because its varietal character seems to shine through. It's intense enough and powerful enough that varietal character actually really expresses itself no matter where it's grown. So that's one of the reasons why it's such a famous grape. And it's also, in a sense, a relatively easy grape to grow. It's also the child of a white grape known as Sauvignon Blanc and a red grape called Cabernet Franc. We think this cross-pollinization was by accident and occurred in the 7th century or so. So it's not all that old of a grape, relatively speaking. Some of the main characteristics of Cabernet Sauvignon are its thick skins, also its small berries. The thick skins make it more resistant to disease, and also it allows for seeing how the skins actually contain most of the flavor compounds and a lot of the tannins and the colors. The thicker the skin, the more concentration of those elements we'll find in the wine itself. And also it has small berry size. So with the small berries, you have a smaller ratio, if you will, of juice to skin. And because all those flavor compounds and color and most of the tannins actually come from the skins themselves, we get a high concentration of those elements in the Cabernet Sauvignon compared to most other wines. So it has, like I say, dark color. It's a full body grape, and it really takes to being aged in oak very, very well. The reason being is because it does have that intense varietal character to it. You can age it in 100% new oak, and it will again show its varietal character through it and not let itself be overpowered by that new oak. More delicate wines such as Pinot Noir or Chardonnay, you put new oak on it, you know, the oak can take over and you won't taste much grape. You might taste nothing but oak in the wines. So another characteristic of Cabernet Sauvignon, it has a little bit of herbaceousness, an herbal quality to it, which mostly comes from methoxypyrazine. And sometimes you get little green pepper and tobacco aspects from it. But this is one of the things that Cabernet Sauvignon is known for. However, in the vineyard, we've learned to grow the fruit to minimize the pyrazines. Sometimes people prefer Cabernet Sauvignon with more bolder, upfront fruit. And so by minimizing those pyrazines in the vineyard, we're able to get a little bit more of that fruit character standing out and less of that herbal quality. But that savory herbalness, you know, that's one of the things that makes Bordeaux Cabernet Sauvignon so famous. So again, it all depends on style of wine. So, kind of a fun thing, the Judgment of Paris, 1976, it was Cabernet Sauvignons, Napa Valley Cabernet Sauvignons put up against the French Bordeaux Cabernet Sauvignons, and well, the favorites of that turned out to be the Napa Valley Cabernet Sauvignons, which blew the world away, and they said, how could this be? Like my French. And anyway, so that's one of the things that really brought Cabernet Sauvignon to the forefront here in North America. So with that, let's taste a little bit of Cabernet Sauvignon. Oh gosh, man, it's been a little while since I've tasted this. And the fruit character, as I said, when I was pouring it, I could just smell this wonderful macerated fruit of black cherry and currant, black currant in particular, coming off of it, and some little bit of baking spices, a little bit of roasted coffee. The roasted coffee isn't as dominant, or I should say prominent, as it used to be. So to me, it's just those notes of roasted coffee are mellowing out a little bit, and boy, the nose is definitely dark fruit oriented. Man, this is a treat, because like you say, it's been a while since I've tasted this. So yeah, just this wonderful, it has wonderful soft tannins to it. So like I say, Cabernet Sauvignon can be known for its high tannin structure, but this is really soft, so it's very drinkable wine. Has ample acidity to it, so it's going to makes it a really nice food-friendly wine, a little more food-friendly too. But it has wonderful, that acidity carries over, these wonderful dark cherry flavors, plum, as I mentioned earlier, currant. So it actually is really kind of reflecting what's in the nose quite a bit, but I'm tasting a little more plum character. I'm not really not getting that so as much in the nose. The other thing that I'm getting out of this is a little bit of blackberry and fig, just, but man, those dark fruit flavors are, they just keep popping. So there's a tiny bit of wood spice in there. There's not a ton of new oak on this, in this particular vintage. We only put about 18% new oak on this one. So, man. So the vintage itself, though, had an early hot spring. It was a very warm summer, too. Gave us medium plus berries, a little larger than normal on Cabernet Sauvignon. And the yields were just a little above average too in 2016. But in the fall it cooled off, but we had some intense bursts of heat during the fall. And so those intermittent blasts of heat just really helped ripen the fruit and get it all ready for harvest. So, but I am just, again, I'm just blown away by the intensity of the fruit down here, and the clarity of the fruit is really impressive on this. So, yeah, that's what I love about it. Well, folks, thank you for joining us here and exploring this 2016 Helix Phinny Hill Cabernet Sauvignon. Next week, We're going to be doing our 2017 Merlot. This is the end of my Abbey notes here. And I'm also going to put a plug in for our 2017 Reserve Chardonnay. We have three or four cases of that left at the winery here. That was aged in a French oak puncheon. It's a 500 liter large oak barrel. Again, that's one of the things we're noted for here at the winery is being very judicious with our oak. So using that large barrel of puncheon, judicious on the Chardonnay. And like I say, we're judicious here on this particular bottle of wine too. It's Cabernet Sauvignon through and through. So here you go, folks. Opportunity to buy a wonderful gem, and not only that, to help second harvest the Spokane. So take care, and remember, drink a little bit of wine here to help keep your sanity here when you're locked up in your house. So take care.